गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज माई लेक्चर नंबर 2 फॉर पोयम नंबर 3, द वॉइस ऑफ द रेन, कंपोज्ड बाय वॉल्ट विटमैन फॉर क्लास 11th, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश. दिस पोयम इज टेकन फ्रॉम योर मेन कोर्स बुक हॉर्नबिल. चिल्ड्रेन, इन लेक्चर नंबर 1 ऑफ दिस पोयम आई गेव यू द कंप्लीट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोयम एंड I told you all the literary devices used by the poet. And in this lecture number 2 of the poem, I will recapitulate the entire poem again and then I will proceed with the textual exercise given on page number 42 in your book. Let's begin with the recapitulation of the poem. And who art thou? Who art thou means who are you? Said I. I refers to the poet Walt Whitman, to the soft falling shower. Soft falling shower means the falling drops of rain, which, strange to tell, gave me an answer as here translated. I am the poem of earth, said the voice of the rain. Eternal I rise impalpable out of the land and the bottomless sea. Here, in these lines, the poet is explaining how he asked a question to the soft falling shower and what answer he got from that rain that was falling and he was conversing with it. Here, who art thou means who are you. Eternal means never ending. And in the last line of this extract number 1, you can see the word impalpable. Impalpable means which cannot be described or that remains untouchable. So, in the above lines, the poet Walt Whitman asks a question from the soft falling shower, that is rain, and his question is, who are you? And the poet gets surprised when he gets an answer from that soft falling shower that answers to his question in a strange to state manner. The rain said that it was the poem of the earth and it rose continuously from the land and bottomless ocean in the form of vapors. So the poet gets surprised to get an answer. The answer which he got from the soft falling shower is translated in his words to make his readers understand. When he asks a question from the rain, who are you? He gets surprised that the answer rain gives him, that the rain is the poem of the earth. This was said by the voice of the rain to the poet. And then it is said eternal. Eternal means never ending. I rise. I means here I refers to the rain. I rise from impalpable. Impalpable means untouchable out of the land and the bottomless sea. Here the rain has given the answer to the poet to tell that the origin of the rain is possible from the land and the bottomless sea. Upward to heaven, whence vaguely formed, altogether changed, and yet the same. I descend to lave the draughts or atomies, dust layers of the globe, and all that in them without me were seeds only, latent, unborn. In extract 1, the poet got an answer to his question from the falling shower, in which the rain has told the poet that the rain is the poem of the earth. And in this second extract, the poet is telling the journey of rain, that from where it is originated and from where does it go to. So here, if you see, upward to heaven, these are the words of the rain spoken to the poet. The rain speaks to the poet and tells that when it is originated from the bottomless sea, then it moves towards heaven. इट गोज अपवर्ड टूवर्ड्स हेवन वेंस. वेंस मीन्स वेयर. वेयर इट इज वेगुअली फॉर्म्ड. वेगुअली मीन्स नॉट क्लियरली, ब्लर. सो द पोएट गॉट अनदर आंसर, अनदर एक्सप्लेनेशन फ्रॉम द रेन, दैट आफ्टर इट इज ऑरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम द बॉटमलेस सी, इट मूव्स टू अपवर्ड towards heaven and there it is vaguely formed, means it is not clearly formed altogether, it changes and remains the same. So the rain tells the poet, when it rises upward towards the sky in the form of vapor, where it changes its form, condenses into water droplets. It also says that although its form gets changed, still it remains the same. And the rain comes down to wash the draughts. It's written, I descend. Descend and ascend that you have studied. Ascend means increasing order, ascending order. Descend means decreasing. Then the rain tells the poet that I means the rain, descend to lave. Lave means wash or bathe. The rain tells the poet, then I come down to wash the draughts and provide water. It also washes away the dust and small particles from the earth's surface. It's written, lave the draughts, atomies. Atomies means small particles. And dust layers of the globe. Globe means earth surface. So the poet is told by the rain that it also washes away the dust and small particles from the earth surface, and the seeds inside the earth grow into a plant because of the water provided by the rain. So it tells the poet that it gives life to the seeds, which remain only latent. Latent means hidden, buried, and unborn. They get their life possibly done due to the arrival of the rain. I explain you in simple words. The poet is told by the rain that it rises upward towards the sky in the form of vapor, where it changes its form, and it also says that although its form gets changed, but it still remains the same. And then the rain comes down to wash the draughts in the water and provide water to the earth, and it also washes away the dust and the small particles from the earth's surface. And the seeds that remain hidden or unborn inside the earth grow into a plant because of the water provided by the rain. So indirectly, the poet is told by rain that it's originated from the earth and comes back to give life to its own origin. This is the main theme that the poet is trying to teach indirectly to his readers. He says, the poem of the earth, that is rain, that got its life possible from the bottomless sea and earth, and when it moves towards heaven and changes its form there, comes back down into the form of rain to give life back to its own origin. So here there is a hidden meaning that we need to understand. When a child is born through parents and then he grows up, and when he grows up, then his parents also grow older. That is the time to give life back to your own origin. When you were a child, you were taken care properly by your parents. And similarly, when you become an adult, your parents grow old. So in their old age, it is better to give their life back to them. And forever, by day and night, I give back life to my own origin and make pure and beautify it. For song, issuing from its birthplace after fulfillment, wandering, wrecked or unwrecked, duly with love returns. In this last extract, the word wrecked or unwrecked, that means whether cared for or not cared for. It doesn't affect the rain nor the poet if someone listened to the poet or the rain or not. So the rain in these lines says that by day and night it provides life, care, enrichment and water to the place from where it originated. The rain keeps enhancing the beauty and purity of the earth by preparing a life cycle for itself again. The rain is like a song that originates from its birthplace, just like the heart of the singer, and travels to fulfill the earth's needs and wonders. It finally comes back to the place from where it originated. Whether it is ruined or not, it returns to the original position with a lot of love to its birthplace. So children, this was the complete explanation of the poem. As you know, the poem is not very lengthy and it's very easy to understand as well. Now, for your convenience, let me explain you the poem in nutshell so that you can understand it better. In this poem, the poet Walt Whitman asks the soft falling shower, "Who are you?" To which the rain replies that she is the poem of earth, and it is a strange thing for the rain to reply to the poet. The rain told the poet that she cannot be touched as she rises in the form of water vapors in the sky from the land and the bottomless sea. It changes its shape, yet it remains the same. The vapor changes into clouds due to condensation. Then it falls back to the surface or on the surface of the earth to provide water to the drought-prone areas and to beautify and purify the earth, which is its birthplace. Then it provides life to the seeds inside the earth and helps them grow. The rain doesn't care if anyone bothers about her deeds or not. She completes her work and comes back home. The poet also compares the rain with the song, as they both share a common journey. The song also originates from the heart of the singer, travels across to fulfill the aim, and comes back with due love for the singer, that is its originator. This is the entire poem, which teaches us a lesson that we must try to give life back to our own origin. You can associate it with the life of a child. You can associate it with the song issued by a poet, and so on. So, this was the complete explanation of the poem, The Voice of the Rain, given by Walt Whitman. Children, let's discuss the exercise now. If you see on page number 42, your exercise begins with "Think it out." Question number 1. There are two voices in the poem. Who do they belong to, and which lines indicate this? If you have understood the poem, you would have noticed the entire poem tells us or gives us two voices. One is of the poet and one is the voice of the rain. So, I tell you the complete answer that you can write in your Fair English notebook of this question. That is, the two voices in the poem are the voice of the rain and the voice of the poet. The lines which indicate the voice of the rain are, "I am the poem of earth," said the voice of the rain. And the lines which indicate the voice of the poet are, "And who art thou," said I to the soft falling shower. So these are the two different lines which indicate the words spoken by the poet and the answer given by the voice, by the falling shower to the poet. Now we are proceeding to question number 2, that is, what does the phrase strange to tell mean? So you would have noticed that strange to tell means it was strange that the poet asked a question to the falling shower and the falling shower replied to the poet's question in the words that were understood by the poet. So it was strange for the poet to tell. So the answer to this question would be, the phrase strange to tell means that it was strange for the soft falling rain to reply to the poet's question. When the poet asked the rain, "Who are you?" the rain replied, "I am the poem of earth." Now question number 3 is, there is a parallel drawn between rain and music. Which words indicate this? Explain the similarity between the two. Children, in the poem The Voice of the Rain, the poet has shown that rain and music are similar because they return to the place of their origin and spread happiness all around. Therefore, the lines for the song issuing from its birthplace after fulfillment, wandering, wrecked or unwrecked, duly with love returns. These lines, if you have noticed, are given in the end of the poem. And these lines draw a parallel between rain and music. Here, the poet Walt Whitman compares the life cycle of the rain and the song. As the song originated from the heart of the singer, wanders to the world, whether liked or unliked, comes back to its birthplace in the end with lots of love. Similarly, the rain originates from earth, that is its birthplace, fulfills its duty to beautify and purify the earth, and wanders and comes back with love for its creator. So this is the similarity and the parallel drawn between the rain and the music, and the poet has given these lines to show that similarity between the two very clearly in his poem. Now I'll discuss question number 4 with you. How is the cyclic movement of rain brought out in the poem? Compare it with what you have learnt in science. Here, the poet is asking to describe the cyclic movement of rain which he has given to us in his poem. The water rises from the land and the bottomless sea in the form of vapor. It then changes its form, transforms itself into clouds. It comes down to the earth in the form of rain to wash drought, provide water, give life to unborn and latent seeds inside the earth. The rain purifies and beautifies the earth. Similarly, he says in science, the water is evaporated in the form of water vapor, condenses in the sky to form clouds, and then rains down in the form of water into rivers, streams, ground, ocean, etc. In the poem, the rain describes its eternal journey itself, which he has compared with science. So, he has written very beautifully the cyclic movement of rain in his poem, which can easily be compared with the present day science. And now question number 5 is, why are the last two lines put within brackets? So if you see in your book, poet has put last two lines within the bracket and now he is asking the reason for the same. So the answer we can give to this question is, the last two lines are put within bracket because they are the observations made by the poet and his thoughts. He made a similarity between the rain and the music. And these lines are not the part of rain's answer. They are additional comments by the poet to show the similarity between the rain and the music. Therefore, the poet has put these lines within bracket because they are giving us a symbolic meaning in which we are comparing the rain with the music. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, दैट इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर टेक्सुअल एक्सरसाइज, इन विच द पोइट हैज आस्क्ड अस टू लिस्ट द पेयर ऑफ ऑपोजिट्स फाउंड इन द पोयम. सो इफ यू नोटिस इन लाइन नंबर 7, यू फाइंड देयर आर वर्ड्स चेंज्ड एंड सेम. दीज आर द वर्ड्स विच आर ऑपोजिट टू ईच अदर. देन यू सी इन लाइन नंबर 12, इट इज रिटन डे एंड नाइट. They are also opposite of each other. And then in line number 15, the poet has written rigged or unrigged. Rigged and unrigged are also opposite of each other. And then you can notice in line number 4 and in line number 6, it is written I rise. And then in line 6, you can see I descend. Rise and descend are also opposite of each other. So these are the four pairs of opposites used by the poet in his poem that you can list in your notebook. On the basis of understanding the poem, you are supposed to answer all these discussed questions, question number 1 to 6 in your Fair English notebook, and don't forget to learn them as well. So first you learn and then write all these discussed question answers in your Fair English notebook. By the time, thank you. Have a nice day.